Playing kartal so swiftly. Not so, you gone. Kartal not so swiftly, slowly, according to the, you should follow the singer. Now the singer has to follow you. Yeah, gone.
Thank you.
सदस्यमाद भक्त सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णविंद की जय। नामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तविंद की जय। श्री राधा कृष्ण गो गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिवर्धन की जय। वृंदावन धाम की जय। नवद्वीप धाम की जय। गंगा माई की जय। जमुना माई की जय। तुलसी देवी की जय। भक्ति देवी की जय। स्वामी तो भक्तबिंद की जय। ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमल। ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमल। ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमल। थैंक यू वेरी मच। हरे कृष्ण। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी। राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी। गोपीजन बल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। गोपीजन बल्लभ गिरिवर धारी।
Thank you.
पीजन बल्लभ गिरिवर धाटी गोपीजन बल्लभ गिरिवर धाटी नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीर बन जाती जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव कुंज चार्य सत्र सदस्य मौल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद की जय अनंत कोटि वैष्णवंद की जय रामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद की जय श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गौ गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिवर्धन की जय वृंदावन धाम की जय नवद्वीप धाम की जय गंगा माई की जय जमुना माई की जय तुलसी देवी की जय भक्ति देवी की जय सामवेद भक्तवृंद की जय ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमल वर्ल्ड ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमल वर्ल्ड ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असमल वर्ल्ड थैंक यू वेरी मच ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय तथा परम हंसानां मुनीनां अमलात्मनां भक्ति योगा अनार्थ तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं कथं पश्येमहि स्त्रियः तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं कथं पश्येमहि स्त्रियः तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलमात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं कथं पश्येमहि स्त्रियः तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं कथं पश्येमहि स्त्रियः तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं कथं पश्येमहि स्त्रियः धन्यवाद तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं कथं पश्येमहि स्त्रियः तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं कथं पश्येमहि स्त्रियः यस् यस् गर्ल्स् नौ तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं वेरी गुड् यस् गान् तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं कथं पश्येमहि स्त्रियः तथा परमहंसानां मुनीनामलात्मनां भक्तियोगाभिधानार्थं कथं पश्येमहि स्त्रियः दैट्स ऑल What meaning?
Besides that,
Bhakti Yoga,
the science of devotional service. science of devotional service unto the hearts of the advanced transcendentalists and material speculators who are purified by being able to discriminate between matter and spirit. How then can we women know you perfectly?
So, Kunti Devi, she is submissively, this is the symptom of Vaishnava. The Lord Krishna has come to Kunti Devi to take the dust off her feet, because Krishna considers Kunti Devi as her aunt. To show her respect, Krishna used to touch the feet of Kunti Devi. But Kunti Devi, although she is in such exalted position, practically on the level of Yashoda Mai, such a great devotee, so she is so submissive that, Krishna, you are meant for the Paramahansas. And what we can see you, we are women. So, as it is said in the Bhagavad Gita, Sriya Vaishyas Tatha Shudra. In another place in the Bhagavad, it is said, Sri Shudra Dijabandhunam. Shudra, Sri and Dijabandhu. Dijabandhu means those who are born in Brahmin family or Kshatriya family, high caste. According to Vedic system, there are four divisions. Chaturbarnam maya system gunakar. According to quality and war, the first class man is the Brahmana, intellect. The next Kshatriya, the next Vaishya, the next Shudra. So, according to this classification, woman, Shudra and Dijabandhu. Dijabandhu, they are taken in the same category. Dijabandhu means born in Brahmin family, Kshatriya family, but has no qualification. The thing is to be considered by qualification. It is very practical. Suppose one man is born the son of a high court judge. So it does not mean that because he is a son of a high court judge, he is also high court judge. This is going on. Because one happens to take birth in a Brahmin family, without any qualification, he claims to become a Brahmin. That is the fall down of Vedic civilization in India. A rascal number one, he is claiming that he is Brahmin, without any qualification. His qualification is less than a Shudra, still he is claiming, and that is being accepted. It is clearly stated, guna karma vibhavas, without qualification. The Brahmana means the qualification. It is not this body. There are so many arguments, but they won't hear. They are very much against in my movement, because I am making Brahmins from Europe and America. They are against me. But don't care, we don't care for them. Neither any reasonable man will care for them. But there is a propaganda against me. Even amongst my god-brothers, they are making, because they cannot do it, so find out some fault, you see. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Prithivite ache jato nagaradigram, sarvatra prachar haive morna. In every town, city, village of the world, his cult will be preached. What is his cult? Does it mean that the Europeans and Americans will not become Brahmin? Because Vaishnava cult means past Brahminism. Past Brahminism. Manchabhyabhicharini bhakti yogina ca shivate sagunan samatittaitan brahma bhuyaya kalpa. He, bhakti yoga, one who takes to bhakti yoga, he immediately comes into the transcendental platform, brahma bhuta. What is speak of? Brahman. So these stereotyped, crippled ideas has killed Vedic civilization. Now we are again reviving. It is meant for everyone. Krishna says, Māṅ hi pārtha vipā śrītya jepīṣu pāpa jonaya śriyā śudrā tathā vaiṣyā sthīpi jānti parāṅgati. Krishna says, although ordinarily we take śriyā means woman, śudrā and vaiṣyā in the lower class grade, but when one becomes a devotee, his or she is no more in the lower grade. Tipi janti parangati. The devotional service is so nice that anyone, ordinarily, woman is taken less intelligent, Shudra is taken less intelligent, Vaishya is taken less intelligent. But if he takes to Krishna consciousness, he is the most intelligent. Krishna je bhaje sevara chotur. This is the statement in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Anyone who has taken to Krishna consciousness, he is the most intelligent. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Guru Krishna kripaya paya bhakti latabi. কোন ভাগ্যবান জীব এইরূপে ব্রহ্মাণ্ড ভ্রমিতে কোন ভাগ্যবান জীব. দি কৃষ্ণ কনসিয়াসনেস মুভমেন্ট ইজ নট ফর দি রেচেড আনফর্চুনেট ক্লাস অফ মেন, নো, ইট ইজ মেন্ট ফর দি মোস্ট ফর্চুনেট ম্যান. এনি ওয়ান হু হ্যাজ টেকন টু কৃষ্ণ কনসিয়াসনেস, হি ইজ টু বি কনসিডার্ড অ্যাজ দি মোস্ট ফর্চুনেট ম্যান. Because he has got the line of action, how his life will be perfect. Therefore, anyone who is in Krishna consciousness and discharging the duties nicely, he is the most fortunate man, most perfect man. That is Kunti Devi is humbly submitting. Although his womanly body, she is a devotee, she is not like ordinary woman, less intelligent. She is the most, she has recognized Krishna, that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Although he has come to me materially as my nephew to offer me respect, but he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, in the previous verse, she said, alakshaṁ sarva-bhūtānā antarbhahi avasthita. You are not seen by ordinary man, although you are inside and outside. In another verse also, nalakṣase mūra-dirśā. Fools and rascals cannot see you. That means Kunti sees him. Unless she sees Krishna as he is, how she can say, Mūra Dirśā, na rakṣase? And he says, Prakite para, you are transcendental to this material creation. So here also, he continues her humbleness. This humbleness is very good in devotional service. Therefore, Chaitanya, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teaches us Tinarapi suni chena tarurapi sahishnuna. One should be tolerant than the trees and humbler than the grass to make progress in spiritual life. Because there will be so many disturbances. Because Maya, we are living just like if we are in the ocean. See, you cannot expect very peaceful situation in the ocean. It must be always tilting. Even your big ship, it is also not very fixed up position. At any moment there may be tumultuous waves. So in this material world, you should always expect danger. You cannot expect very peaceful life within this material. Padang padanga jada vipadang. Shastra says, in every step there is danger. But if you become a devotee, then you escape. Maya mitang tarantita. Otherwise, so in the beginning, if you take to Krishna consciousness, there will be so many disturbances by the Maya. Maya will test you. How far you are fixed up. She will test you. She is also agent of Krishna. She does not allow anyone who is meant for disturbing Krishna. Therefore, she tests very rigidly. Whether you have taken Krishna consciousness to disturb Krishna, or you are actually serious. That is Maya's business. So, there will be, in the beginning, test by the Maya, and you will feel so much disturbances in making progress in Krishna consciousness. But if you remain steady, steady means if you follow the rules and regulations and chant 16 down, then you will remain steady. And if you neglect, then Maya will capture you. Immediately, Maya is always ready. We are in the ocean. At any moment, we will be disturbed. Therefore, one who is not disturbed at all, he is called Paramahamsa. Therefore, Kunti Devi said, Tatha Paramahamsanam. Parama means ultimate. Hamsa means swan. Paramahamsa means the perfect hamsa. Hamsa, it is said that if you, hamsa means swan, if you give to swan milk mixed with water, she will take the milk part and leave aside the water part. Similarly, a person who knows what is this material world is made of two natures, the inferior nature and the superior nature. The superior nature means spiritual life, and inferior nature is material life. So a person who gives up the material part of this world and takes only the spiritual part, he is called Paramahamsa. Paramahamsa. A spiritual part means one who knows that whatever is working in this material, just like this body, your body, my body. Anyone who knows that this movement, the activities of this body is due to the soul which is within this body. That is the real fact, and this is only outward covering. Similarly, one who knows that Krishna is the center of this all activity, he is Paramahamsa. He is Paramahamsa. He knows the fact. So, Bhakti Yoga is for the Paramahamsa, one who knows that Krishna is the central fact. Aham adirhi devana matta sarvang pravartate. So one who knows that Krishna is the cause of all causes, he not only theoretically but practically convenes, he is Paramahansa. So Kunti Devi says that you are meant for the Paramahansas, not for the rascals and fools. You are meant for the Paramahansa. Tatha Paramahansana Munina. Munina means those who are thoughtful, also mental speculators, they are called Muni. Muninam Amalatmanam Amala. There is no dirty things in their heart. Materialistic person means full of dirty things within the heart. What is the dirty thing? That lust and greediness. That's all. This is the dirty things. All materialistic person, they are lusty and greedy. Therefore, their heart is full of dirty things. And amalatmana means those are freed from these two things, lust and greediness. Samalatmananam. For them, bhakti yogam. This bhakti yogam is meant for the clean heart, not the lusty and greedy. That is not, they may try, they will gradually advance. But once he is situated in bhakti yoga, there is no more lust and greediness. Virakti annatra sya. This is the test. Whether one has become free from lusty desires and greediness, then he is situated in bhakti yoga. He is Paramahansa. So Kunti Devi, by humble submission, that you are meant for the Paramahansa, for the Amalatmanam, for the Muninam, and who are engaged in bhakti yoga, and what we are simply women. We are in the lower grade. How he can understand you? This is humbleness. Although she understands everything, but still she is taking the position of an ordinary woman, that how can I understand you? Thank you very much. Thank you. Chant Hare
Krishna, 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 Krishna,
नंद गौड़ी वैष्णविंद की जय। नवाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तविंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गौर गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिवर्धन की जय। वृंदावन धाम की जय। नवद्वीप धाम की जय। स्वामी तो भक्तविंद की जय। ऑल ग्लोरी टू देयर स्मॉल ऑल ग्लोरी टू देयर स्मॉल All glories to their Lord. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Hey. gadadhar Shiva Sari Gaur Atamendra
Yeah.
Bhaktivinodas Thakur Ji.
Jai.
Prem se kaho Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaur Bhaktivinoda Ki Jai.
Jai.
Sri Radha Krishna Gaur Gopinath Swam Kunda Radha Kunda Giridhavadhan Ki Jai.
Jai.
Vrindavan Dham Ki Jai.
Jai.
Navadeep Dham Ki Jai.
Jai.
गंगा माई की जय, यमुना माई की जय, तुलसी देवी की जय, भक्ति देवी की जय, सावित भक्तविंद की जय, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू देशमुख, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू देशमुख, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू देशमुख, थैंक यू वेरी मच. भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद की जय. अनंत गौड़ी वैष्णविंद की जय. रामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय. प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तविंद की जय. श्री राधा कृष्ण गौर गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिगोवर्धन की जय. वृंदावन धाम की जय. नवद्वीप धाम की जय. स्वामी तो भक्तविंद की जय. ऑल ग्लोरी टू देशमुख बोल. ऑल ग्लोरी टू देशमुख. ऑल ग्लोरी टू देशमुख. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Krishnaya, Vasudevaya, Devaki, Nandanaya,
Nanda, Toba,
Kumaraya,
Govindaya,
Namo, Krishnaya, Vasudevaya, Devaki Nandanaya cha
Nanda
Gopa Kumaraya
Govindaya Namo Nama
Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya cha Nanda Gopa Kumaraya Vasudevaya
Devaki Nandanaya cha
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Devaki Nandanaya cha
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Krishnaya Vasudevaya Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Devaki Nandanaya cha
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya Govindaya Namo Namaha
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Devaki Nandanaya cha
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Devaki Nandanaya cha
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Devaki Nandanaya cha
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Devaki Nandanaya cha
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Devaki
Nandanaya cha
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Devaki Nandanaya cha
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Krishnaya Vasudevaya
Devaki Nandanaya cha Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Govindaya Namo Namaha
Nanda Gopa Kumaraya
Govindaya
Namo Namo
Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nanda Naya Cha Nanda Gopa Kumaraya Govindaya Namo Namo
That's right.
Unto the Lord, who has become the son of Vasudeva, the pleasure of Devaki, the boy of Nanda, and the other cowherd men of Vrindavan, and the enlivener of the cows and the senses.
So, in the beginning, Kunti Devi said that Namasse Purushantadhyam Isharam Prakriti Param. I offer my obeisances unto the person, Purusham, who is Prakriti Param, who is beyond this material manifest. Krishna is complete spirit, soul, super soul. He has no material body. So in the beginning, Kunti Devi gave us this understanding that God, the Supreme Purusha, Purusha means person. He is not imperson, Purusha. But he is not a Purusha of this material world, not a personality of this material creation. That is to be understood. The impersonalist cannot accommodate in their poor fund of knowledge how the Supreme Absolute Truth can become a person. Because whenever they think of person, they think of a person of this material world. That is their defect. So, their poor fund of knowledge. Why God should be a person of this material world? So that was clear in the beginning. Prakriti para, beyond this material creation. But he is a person. So now that personality, although alaksham, invisible, now by the grace of Kunti, we can understand that although the Supreme Person is invisible, now he has appeared to be visible, Krishna. Therefore he says, Krishnaya Vasudevaya. Vasudeva conception, sometimes the impersonalists, they have Vasudeva conception, means all-pervading. So Kunti Devi is pointing out that Vasudeva is Krishna, all-pervading. Krishna, by his Vasudeva feature, he is all-pervading. Ishara sarva-bhutanam riddhese arjuna tishtati. This feature of Krishna, Krishna, the original person, has got three features. As the Supreme Personality of Godhead,
as all-pervading Paramatma, Super Soul, and impersonal Brahma effulgence. So, those who are interested in Bhakti Yoga, they have no business with the impersonal Brahma effulgence. That is for common man. Common man. Just like you can try to understand, those who are inhabitants of the sun planet, what they have got to do with the sun sign? That is the most insignificant thing for them, sun sign. Similarly, those who are advanced in spiritual life, they are interested in the person, Purusham, Vasudeva, Purusham. That realization takes place, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, after many, many births, bahunam janmanam anti, at the end of many, many births. These impersonalists who are very much attached to the Brahma effulgence, such persons, they are called jnani. They are trying to understand the absolute truth by dint of their knowledge. But they do not know that their knowledge is very imperfect and limited. And Krishna, the absolute truth, is unlimited. You cannot approach the unlimited by your limited knowledge. That is not possible. So, by the grace of devotees like Kunti Devi, we can understand that here is the Vasudeva, the all-pervading absolute truth, Paramatma, Vasudeva is here, Krishnaya, Vasudevaya. So this Vasudeva realization is possible by the impersonalist after many, many births. Not very easily. Bhavanam janvanamante jnanavan manga prabhadate Vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatma sudurlava. Sudurlava. Very rare. Mahatma, broad-minded. But one who cannot understand Krishna, they are crippled-minded. They are not broad-minded. If one becomes broad-minded, then by the grace of Krishna, he can understand Krishna. Sevanmukha hi jiva, the process is sevanmukha. Service. Service beginning with the tongue, Vasudeva realization is possible. The service, the first service is opulent. Six kinds of opulence. Why you are troubling, why you are rotting in this material world? This is the greatest service, Krishna consciousness. But Maya is very strong, still it is the duty of every Krishna bhakta to try to enlighten everyone to Krishna consciousness, just like Kunti Devi is pointing out. First of all, she said, alaksam sarva-bhutanam antar-bahi-avasthita. Although Krishna, the Supreme Person, is without and within, still, to the rascals and fools, is invisible. Therefore, she is pointing out, here is the Lord, Krishnaya, Vasudeva. He is the all-pervading Supreme Personality of Godhead. But he is very much pleased to become the son of Devaki. Devaki Nandanaya. Devaki Nandanaya. Devaki Nandan is mentioned in the Atharva Veda also. Krishna comes as Devaki Nandan. And his foster father is Nanda Gopa, Nanda Maharaj. So Krishna likes to be related with his devotee as father and mother. Here in this material world, we try to make our relationship with the Supreme as father, but Krishna wants to become the son. Therefore, Nanda Gopal, he takes pleasure to become a devotee's son. The ordinary man, they want God as father, but that is not very pleasing to Krishna. Father means to become father means always botheration, give me this, give me this, give me this, give me this. You see? Of course, Krishna has got immense potencies to supply. Eko ju bahunam vidudhati kama. He can supply everyone as much he wants. He is supplying food to the elephant. He is supplying food to the ant. Why not to the human being? But these rascals, they do not know. They are working day and night like ass to find out bread. And if he goes to church, they are also, give me bread. They are only bread problem, that's all. Although the living entity is the son of the richest, opulent person, but he has created his bread problem. This is called ignorance. He thinks that if I do not solve my bread problem, if I do not drive my trucks day and night, that's such a non-sensibilization, you see. Bread problem. Where is bread problem? Krishna can supply, if he can supply food to the elephant. In Africa, there are millions and millions of African elephants, you know, and they are supplied food. Then Bhagavad says, don't waste your time for this bread problem. Don't waste your time. Tashaiva heta prajate ta kovida na labhati jat bhramatam uparjat. Don't waste your time. How to solve your economic problems? This is nonsense. Of course, it is very revolutionary. People will hate me. The word Swamiji is speaking. But actually, this is the fact. This is another madness. Suppose you have got your rich father, enough food, where is your economic problem? This is madness. There is no economic problem. If you know that my father is the richest man, of this city, then where is my economic problem? Actually, that is the position. We have no economic problem. Everything is there, complete. Purnam, purnamadam, purnamadam, purnat purnamudachati. Everything is complete there. You want water, just see, there are oceans of water. You want purified water. You cannot, although the ocean water is so much, when there is scarcity of water, you have to take help of Krishna. He will evaporate the water, he will make it cloud, then when it is falls down, then it becomes sweet, otherwise you cannot touch. Everything under control. Everything is full, water, light, heat, everything is complete. Purnat purnamudachyate. Purnasa, purnamadaya, purnameva avashishyate. His talk is never finished. Simply you become obedient and the supply is there. You can understand. These Krishna consciousness persons, they have no problem, economic problem. Everything is sufficiently supplied by Krishna. In Los Angeles, the neighbors, that they are very envious. That you do not work, you have no anxiety, and you have got four cars, you are eating so nicely. How is that? They inquire from our devotees. That is the actual fact. We are spending so much money, we have got so many centers. The calculation is about $70,000 we are spending. Who is supplying? Somehow or other we are getting. So there is no problem. You simply become sincere servant of Krishna, everything is there. This is the test. There are envious of us that we do not work, still we have got so much. So why don't you come and join us? That they will not do. You come with us, chant Hare Krishna. No, that I cannot do. All right, then work with your tracks. So. They have made their own position dangerous and others' position also. They say at any moment there may be accident. You see, this is civilization. Nonsense, this is not civilization. Civilization means calmness, peace, prosperity, shanti. In peace and prosperity one should be Krishna conscious, always. Tasyaiva hita prajatita kovida. Lalabhate jat bhramadam uparjat. In the animal life or other than human life, we had worked so much, only for morsel of food, day and night working. But still, the food is there simply. Avidya karma sangha anya titya shakti rishyate. Avidya, this material world, is full of ignorance. So therefore, our endeavor should be how to come out of this ignorance. Tasyaiva hetu. For that reason we should work only. How to come out of this ignorance. Thus, I am this material body, I have to work day and night, and then I shall get my food, then I shall leave. This is ignorance. Tasyaiva hetu prajate. So this ignorance, this life of ignorance we have passed in the forms other than the human being. Animal life, bird's life, beast life. Now, this life should be peaceful, calm and quiet. Jivasya tattva jigyasa, simply for inquiring about the Absolute Truth. That should be the business. Simply. Divasya tattva jigyasa, athato brahma jigyasa. Simply, sit down, just like we are sitting down and inquiring about Krishna. This is life. This is life. But what is this life? Working day and night like ass. No, that is not life. Therefore, Bhagavad says, your life should be engaged for this purpose. Tasyaiva hetu prajatita kovida. Kovida means intelligent. Then how my economic problems will be solved? The answer is, tallabhate dukha badannata sukham. You are after happiness. Are you after distress? No, sir. Then why distress comes upon you? You are not anxious for distress, calamities. Why do they come upon you? Similarly, so far your happiness is also concerned, that will also come upon you. Because your life, according to your karma, is mixed up with some portion of happiness, some portion of distress. If the distress comes without any invitation, the happiness also will come without invitation, without any endeavor. Because you are destined already, that so much happiness, so much distress will have. Destined. So you cannot change it. Try to change your Lord, this material condition of life. That is your only business. Tasyaiva hetu prajatita kovida. Nalabhate jad bhramatam uparjata. Bhramatam uparjata. You have tried. Bhramatam uparjata. Upar means higher planetary system. Sometimes we get our birth in higher planetary system as demigods. And sometimes, although as animals, as cats and dogs, as janma, the stool, this is going on. This is going on according to our karma. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, ei rupe brahmanda bhramite kono bhagwan jeev. Only a fortunate living entity gets this opportunity of association of Krishna and Krishna's devotee. Then his life becomes sublime. Eirupe brahmanda bhramiti kono bhagavan ji guru krishna kripaya paya bhakti lata bij. This bhakti lata bij, the seed of devotional service, chanting Hare Krishna mantra. So Kunti Devi is pointing out that who is the person, Aloksha, invisible? Yeah, Krishna. Krishna, there are so many Krishna. Vasudevaya, the son of Vasudeva. There are many Vasudevas. No, Nandagopa, Nandana, the foster son of Maharaj Nanda. Three times he's pointing, here is Krishna. Krishna, who officially takes his birth as son of Devaki and Vasudeva, but he enjoys the company of Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, the childhood company. This is Krishna's first times. So, Ananda Leela, Maya Vigrahaya. Ananda Leela, Krishna's Leela, first times are all jubilant. Ananda Leela Maya. Anandamaya Vyasa. He is by nature Anandamaya. Krishna will never find Krishna is very unhappy. Krishna is never unhappy. Krishna is always happy. Therefore, Nanda Gopa, Kumaraya, Govindaya. He is happy and whoever associates with him, he is also happy. Govindaya. We are after sense gratification. Go means senses. So if you associate with Krishna, you enjoy your senses affluently, just like the gopis are dancing with Krishna. So there is no scarcity of sense gratification also. But that is not this sense, gross sense gratification. That is spiritual sense. That is spiritual sense. Ananda Chinmaya Sadhu Jalavigrahasya, we chant every day. That sense gratification is Ananda Chinmaya. Chinmaya in the spiritual world, not this third class Ananda with these bodily senses. This is not Ananda. This is an illusion. This is illusion. We are thinking that I am enjoying. But that is not Ananda. This Ananda is not fact because we cannot enjoy this material sense pleasure for long. Everyone has got experience. It is finished. It is finished. But spiritual enjoyment does not finish, it increases. That is the difference. Ananda Chinmaya Sadhu Jalavigrahas. Govindam Adi Purusha. So you have to associate with Govinda. Here is also it is said. Govindaya namo namo. I offer my respectful obeisances to Govind. So this Krishna consciousness moment is so nice. You become directly in contact with Govinda. This deity worship is also directly in contact with Govinda. Sri Vigrahara Dhana Nittanana Sringaratana Mandira Marjanadu. This Vigraha, the deity of Krishna, that is also Krishna's mercy. Because Krishna is Aloksha, invisible, he has become visible for your facility. As you can see, it is not that Krishna is stone or Krishna is wood or Krishna is metal. Krishna is always Krishna. But he appears because you cannot see except wood, stone and metal. He appears like that, wood, stone and metal. But he is not wood, stone, metal. You will get the same facility as Krishna personally. If you associate, you will associate with Krishna. But at the present moment, because Krishna is invisible, therefore he has very kindly taken a form which is visible by you. This is Krishna's mercy. Do not think, here is Krishna, stone Krishna. Krishna is everything. Krishna is everything, so Krishna is stone also. Krishna is stone also. But he is not that stone that cannot act. Krishna act also in the stone form also. Krishna act also in metal form also. And he will perceive that. Sāmeva Spuratvada. The more you give service, the so-called stone also speak with you. There are many instances like that. So we should take to this Krishna consciousness movement according to the Shastra. See, I am very pleased that you are doing nicely, dressing the deity very nicely. More and more in this way, offer Krishna nice prasadam, nice foodstuff, nice dress. Keep the temple very clean. Sri Mandira Marjanadishu. Marjan means cleansing. Either you dress Krishna or cleanse the temple, the effect is the same. Don't think, I am a cleanser and he is a dresser. No, the dresser and the cleanser are the same. Krishna is absolute. In any way, be engaged in Krishna's service, your life will be successful. This is Krishna consciousness movement. So, by the grace of Kunti Devi, we can understand that Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudeva. Vasudeva, another meaning of Vasudeva is that when you come to the platform of Vasudeva, Sattang Visuddham, Vasudeva Shabda. Sattang, Satta, goodness. First of all, you have to come to the platform of goodness. But here in the material world, the goodness is also sometimes contaminated by other low qualities, ignorance and passion. So, by hearing about Krishna, Sinnatang Sagata Krishna, Punna Savana Kita, just like you are hearing about Krishna, similarly, try to hear about Krishna, always, 24 hours, chant about Krishna. In this way, the dirty things will be cleansed. Nasta prayeshu avadrishu nittang bhagavata sivaya. Nittang. Nittang means always. Not that bhagavata saptah, the official. No, not like that. There is another exploitation. In the Bhagavata it is said, nittang bhagavata sivaya. Nittang means daily, 24 hours. Either you read Srimad Bhagavatam or carry out the order of your spiritual master. This is also order. Krishna, Bhagavata is spiritual master, Vishnu, he is also Bhagavata. Acharyas, Bhagavata. Grantha Bhagavata, person Bhagavata. The person Bhagavata or book Bhagavata, you always serve. Nittang Bhagavata Sivaya. Bhagavati uttama sloke bhakti bhavati naishthiki. Then you'll be fixed up. Naishthiki. Nobody can move you. Bhagavati uttama sloke unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So in this way, Krishna consciousness movement should be realized by you, by the process prescribed, and try to give to the people. This is the greatest welfare activities in the world. To awaken Krishna consciousness, the dormant Krishna consciousness. It is, of course, practically you can see, 4 or 5 years ago, none of you were in Krishna consciousness, but it has been awakened. Now you are Krishna consciousness. So others can be awakened also. There is no difficulty. The process is the same. So, by following the footprints of devotees like Kunti, we shall be able to understand, as she is pointing out, Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya Cha Nandagopa Kumaraya. This is Krishna's identification. Just like we take identification of a person, what is your father's name? So here he is giving, presenting God with his father's name, with his mother's name, with his address. We are not impersonal, it's a big idea. No, everything complete, perfect, the identification. If you take advantage of this propagation of Krishna consciousness, then you are certainly benefited. Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Jayam Asmat Paramahamsa Paribhraja Gacharya Ashtatara Sadasamad Bhakta Siddhanta Sarasati Goswami Prabhupada ki jai. Ananta Koti Vaishnavinda ki jai. Ramacharya Srila Haridas Thakur ki jai. Prem se kaho Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda ki jai. Sri Sri Radha Krishna Gaur Gopinath Sam Kundi Radha Kundi Girigavardhan ki jai. Vrindavan Dham ki jai. Navadvip Dham ki jai. Ganga Mai ki jai. Jamuna Mai ki jai. New York Temple ki jai. Samaveda Bhaktavinda ki jai. All glories to the Asmal Lord. All glories to the Asmal Lord. All glories to the Asmal Lord. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Namaste, sir.
Series of dangers.
Series of dangers.
Translation. O Hrishikesha, master of the senses and lord of lords, you have released your mother Devaki, who was long imprisoned and distressed by the envious King Kamsa, and myself and my children from a series of constant dangers.
So, this is the position of devotees. That Devaki, who happens to be the mother of Krishna, she is not ordinary woman who can become the mother of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the most advanced devotee, so that Krishna has agreed to become her son. In his previous life, the husband and wife, they underwent severe austerities, and when Krishna appeared before them and wanted to give them benediction, they wanted a son like God. So, where can be another person who is equal to God? That is not possible. God means there is no equal, there is no greater. Asama urdhva. That is God. God, there cannot be any competition that you are God, I am God, he is God, he is God. No. These are dogs. They are not God. God means without competition. One. God is one. Nobody is greater, asamartha, nobody is greater than him, nobody is equal to him. Everyone is lower. Ekala, Ishar, Krishna, Arsabhritta. Only master is Krishna, God, and everyone's servant. Never mind, even if he is Brahma, Vishnu, or Shiva, big demigods, and what to speak of others. Shiva Virinchi Nutam. In the Shastra it is said that he is offered respect by Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma. They are the topmost demigods. There are demigods. Above the human being, there are demigods. As we are human being, above the lower creatures, lower animals. Similarly, above us, there are demigods. And the most important demigod is Lord Brahma. Lord Brahma is the creator of this universe. And Lord Shiva is the destroyer of this universe. And Lord Vishnu is the maintainer. Lord Vishnu is Krishna himself. So for the maintenance of this material world, there are three gunas, satagun, rajagun, tamagun. So each one of them has taken charge of one department. So Lord Vishnu has taken the department of satagun, and Lord Brahma has taken the department of rajagun. And Lord Shiva has taken the department of tamagun. They are not under the influence of these gunas. Just like as the superintendent of jail, he is not a prisoner. He is controlling an officer. Similarly, Lord Shiva, Lord Vishnu, Lord Brahma, although they are controlling each department, they are not under the controlling department. We may not commit mistake. So, Rishikesha, Krishna is the supreme controller. Rishik means senses. So, we are enjoying our senses, but ultimately, the controller is Krishna. Suppose this is my hand. I am claiming it is my hand. I shall give you a good feast on you. I am very much proud. But I am not controller. The controller is Krishna. If he withdraws the power of the activity of your arm, you become paralyzed. Although you are claiming, it is my hand, I shall use it. But when it is paralyzed, you cannot do anything. Therefore, I may have possessed this hand by the grace of Krishna, but I am not the controller. That is Krishna consciousness. Therefore, a sane man will think that ultimately if this hand is to be controlled by Krishna, then it is meant for Krishna. This is the common sense understanding. I am claiming that it is my hand, this is my leg, this is my ear. Even children say, ask the children, what is this? It is my hand. But we may claim, but actually it is not our hand. It is given. Because I wanted to use my hands in so many ways, Krishna has given all lives. You take this hand, use it. So it is gift of Krishna. Therefore, a sane man is always conscious that whatever I have got in my position, first of all this body and senses, they are actually not mine. I have given all these possessions for utility. So if ultimately everything belongs to Krishna, why it is not utilized for Krishna? That is Krishna consciousness. That is Krishna consciousness. That is intelligence. If I am given all these things for my use, for my sense gratification, but ultimately it belongs to Krishna. Everyone is part and parcel of Krishna. So everyone's senses are also Krishna's. So when these senses are utilized for Krishna's service, that is perfection of life. And so long it is utilized for my sense gratification, it is Maya. Therefore, bhakti means Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanam Bhakti Ruchat. Rishikena, by the senses, this Rishikesa, Sevanam, when you serve Rishikesa, really master of the senses, That is called bhakti. A very simple description, definition of bhakti. Rishikena Rishikesa Sevana. Rishikesa Sevana. Not Rishik Sevana. Rishik means senses. So, when senses are used for sense gratification, that is Maya. And when senses are used for the gratification of the master of the senses, that is called bhakti. Very simple definition. Anyone can understand. So, generally, in this material world, everyone is using the senses for sense gratification. That's all. That is their bondage. That is Maya, illusion. And when he comes to Krishna consciousness, purified, when he understands that actually these senses are meant for satisfying Krishna, then he is liberated person. Mukta, Mukta Purush, liberated person. Iha jasya harir dasya karmana manasa bhacha. When one comes to this position, that my senses are meant for serving the master of the senses, Rishikesha. The master of the senses is sitting within your heart. In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishta. I am seated in everyone's heart. Matta smriti jnanam apohananj. From me, remembrance, knowledge, and forgetfulness is coming. So, why that? Because Krishna is so merciful. If I want to use my senses in a certain way, not my senses, it is Krishna's given. So Krishna gives the chance, all right, utilize it. Suppose I have got tongue. If I want, Krishna, I want to eat stool. I want to taste stool. Yes, Krishna will say, yes, you can take this body of hog and eat stool. The master is there, Krishna. Therefore Krishna says, Matta smriti jnanam apaharanj. He gives you the body, reminds you, my dear living entity, you wanted to eat stool, now you have got a proper body. Now utilize, here is stool also. Similarly, if you want to become demigod, that also Krishna gives you chance. Anything, there are 8,400,000 forms of life. If you want to engage your senses in any type of body, Krishna is giving you, come on, here is the body you take. But by using our senses, ultimately we become senseless. Therefore Krishna says, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekam śaraṇam. Don't do like this. Your senses are meant for serving me. So you are misusing it. By misusing, you are being entrapped in different types of body. Therefore, to get relief from this tedious business of accepting one body and giving it up, again another body, anything another, to continue this material existence, if you give up this process of sense gratification and surrender unto me, then you are saved. This is Krishna consciousness. So, at the present moment, our senses are contaminated. I am thinking I am American. So, my senses should be utilized for the service of my country, my society, my nation, big, big leaders, big, big, so many things. The real concept is that I am American. So, my senses are American senses. So, it must be utilized for America. Similarly, Indians, is thinking, or others are thinking, but none of them do know it, that senses belong to Krishna. This is ignorance. No intelligence. They are thinking for the time being that these senses, upadhi, designate American senses, Indian senses, African senses. No, this is called Maya. It is covered. Therefore, bhakti means sarvapadhi vinirmuktam. When your senses will be uncontaminated with all these diseases, that is the beginning of bhakti. If I think I am American, why shall I take Krishna consciousness? It is Hindu god. But that is foolishness. If I think I am Mohammedan, I am Christian, then you are gone. But if we purify the senses, that I am spirit soul, the supreme spirit soul is Krishna, I am part and parcel of Krishna, therefore it is my duty to serve Krishna, then you become free immediately. You are no more American, Indian, or African, or this or that. You are Krishnaite, Krishna conscious. That is what. Therefore, Kunti Devi says, Rishikesha, my dear Krishna, you are the master of the senses. And for the sense gratification, we are fallen in this material condition of life, different varieties of life. So, we are suffering. In the suffering to the extreme, even one becomes Krishna's mother, because this is material world, she is also put into suffering. But to speak of others, Devaki is so advanced that she has become the mother of Krishna. But still, he is put into difficulties. Difficulties by whom? By his brother, Kamsa. So this world is like that. Try to understand. Even you become Krishna's mother, and even your brother, who is very nearest relative, the world is such, jealous, that if one's personal interest is hampered, everyone will be ready to give you trouble. This is the one. Everyone, even if his brother, even his father, what to speak of others? Khalena. Khala means jealous. This material world is jealous, envious. I am envious of you, you are envious of me. This is our business. This is our business. Therefore, this Krishna consciousness movement is for such person who is no more jealous, who is no more envious. Perfect person. Dharma projita koita vayatra parama nirma saranang satang vastava vastu vidyama. Those who are jealous and envious, they are within this material world. And those who are not jealous, they are in the spiritual world. Just a simple thing. You test yourself. Whether I am jealous, envious of my other associates, friends, everything, then I am in the material world. And if I am not jealous, then I am the spiritual. Anyone can test. There is no question of whether I am spiritually advanced or not. You can test yourself. Bhakti parishanu bhava virakti annatrasyat. Just like if you are eating, you will understand whether you are satisfied, whether your hunger is satisfied. You haven't got to take certificate from others. Similarly, if you test yourself, whether you are jealous, whether you are envious, then you are in the material. And if you are not jealous, if you are not envious, then in the spiritual world. then you can serve Krishna very nicely. If you are not jealous, because power, jealous, envious has began from Krishna, just like the Mahabharata. Why Krishna shall be God? I am also God. So this is the beginning of material life. To become envious of Krishna. Why Krishna shall be enjoyed? I shall be enjoyed. Why Krishna shall enjoy the gopis? I shall become Krishna and enjoy, make a society of gopis and enjoy. This is Maya. Nobody can be enjoyer. Krishna therefore says, Bhokkaram Jagat. See, Krishna is the only enjoyer. And if we supply ingredients for his enjoyment, that is our perfection of life. And if we want to imitate Krishna, that I shall become a god, I shall become an imitator, enjoyer, then you are in the mind. Simply, our business is just like the gopis' life. Krishna is enjoying, and they are supplying the ingredients of enjoyment. Yes. This is bhakti. We are meant for Krishna is supplying the servant and master. The servant is being supplied all the necessities by the master. But the servant's duty is to serve the master. That's all. Ego bahunangju vidudhati kaman nitya nityanam chetanas chetanas. These are the bathing infant. Krishna is supplying you immense. All the necessities of life. There is no scarcity, there is no economic problem. You simply try to serve Krishna, then everything is complete. Because he is Rishikesha. There is so much, if Krishna desires, there may be ample supplies. Just like in your country, there is ample supplies. In other country, I went to Switzerland, everything is imported, no supply. The supply is only snow. Take as much snow as you like. You see, similarly, everything is under the control of Krishna. If you become devotee, then there is no snow supply, simply food supply. And if you don't become devotee, be covered with snow, that's all. Covered with cloud. Everything is under Krishna's control. So actually there is no scarcity. The scarcity is Krishna consciousness. So if you become Krishna conscious, then everything is ample. There is no scarcity. This is the problem. Tayarishikesha. And yet we say, Tayarish, Jatharishikesha Khalina Devata. The world is full of dangers. But Devaki, again, Kunti Devi says, but because Devaki is your devotee, you saved her from the distresses offered by her envious brother. As soon as the brother heard that my sister's son, eighth son of my sister, will kill me, he was ready immediately to kill Devaki. So he was pacified by Devaki's husband. It is the duty of the husband to give protection. Yeah, my dear brother-in-law, why you are envious to your sister? After all, your sister will not kill you, her son will kill you. That is the problem. So I shall deliver all the sons to you, then you can do whatever you like. Why you are killing this innocent girl? Newly married, she is your younger sister, just like your daughter, you should give her protection. What you are doing this? So Kansa became pacified. He believed in the words of Vasudeva that he will deliver all the sons, and if you like, can kill. He thought, let me save the present situation. After all, later on, when Kansa gets a nephew, he may forget this enviousness, but he is never to forget. Yeah. He killed all the sons and kept them in prison. Sucharpita, Bodhya, Atichiram. Atichiram meant for a long time. So, you are saved. Devaki, you are saved after all. Similarly, if we take the position of Devaki and Kunti, Kunti just like with her sons, Pancha Pandav, five Pandav, after she became widow, the whole plan was Dhritarashtra's, how to kill these children of my younger brother, because by chance I was blind, so I could not get the throne of the kingdom. My younger brother got it. Now he is dead. Then at least my sons, they should get the throne. That was his policy, Dhritarashtra's policy. I could not get. This is material propensities. I shall be happy, my sons shall be happy, my community shall be happy, my nation shall be happy. These are extended selfishness. Nobody is thinking Krishna, how Krishna will be happy. Everyone is thinking in his own terms, how I shall be happy, how my children shall be happy, my community shall be happy, my society shall be happy, my nation. This is the struggle for existence. Everybody will find. This is material existence. Nobody is thinking how Krishna will be happy. Therefore, this Krishna consciousness is very sublime. Try to understand from Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita. And Rishikena Rishikesha Sevanam. And try to engage your senses for the service of the master of the senses, then you'll be happy. Thank you very much.